Hi everyone, so welcome to SEMA 2023. We made it with the Barracuda. We're on the Penske Racing Sharks booth. They sponsored us with the suspension on the car. We did the theme on the car is an old Trans Am build. The idea was, what if Plymouth had gone racing in 68 with an A-body instead of 1970 with the AAR CUDAs? So this is a 68 CUDA fastback. We did a wide body, 5-inch wider, total front and rear. It's all metal, no bolt-on fender fairs, nothing like this. And then there's a bit more bodywork also on the hood with hood vents, louvers, shaved rear, shaved front. We also relocated the cut lines in the front just to get everything lined up between the top and the bottom of the fascia. And then in terms of aero, front air dam, rear wing, to just go together and have a stable car. Like I said, the car is quite a lot wider than stock. We're running Toyo tires, R-AAA car, on mini light wheels, 16 by 9. Behind these we have AP Racing 6 caliper front brakes that I got from a NASCAR team, so it's a road racing setup. They're very lightweight, very powerful. In terms of the rest of the vehicle, I wanted to have a vehicle that drives and runs like an old Trans Am car, but I wanted to have modern safety features. So the roll cage is quite a bit beefed up compared to one of the cars from back in the day. We have tubing going from the front frame rails across the firewall into the cockpit, all the way inside the side skirts at the bottom, and then back into the frame rails at the back, under the rear of the back, around the fuel cell. So it's tied in everywhere in the car. I think I counted we have 37 tubes in the car, so that's quite a bit. And I also triangulated the rear suspension into the roll cage. So where the rear shocks actually push, that actually pushes all the way down to the bottom of the main hub. One of the sponsors that we have also is Recaro. We have P1300 GT lightweight seats, so they're full carbon fiber, and they have these really trick lower brackets where the bracket actually doesn't move, and the rails are actually on the side of the seat. So it's a really neat package. It's really easy to actually set it up. You just put the bracket down, bolt it to the car, and then the seat comes and slides into it, clips in it, and then you have 8 bolts on the inside through the shell that bolt into the bracket. The harnesses, we have 6-point Luke harnesses. They're all black and they have the Barracuda logo stitched on it, so nice little touch. On the rest of the interior, Momo steering wheel, Motion Works steering column, Tifton 600 series pedal box with remote reservoirs that are on the center on the transmission tunnel. There's electric cutoff switch and fire extinguisher in the middle as well. And then I built a bracket so that my brake bias setup adjustment knob is attached to the seat actually. So it's always in the same position, it's easy to reach. You never have to really think about it. When we go to the back, you can see we have remote canisters on the shocks. So Penske did a really neat trick on this. They actually laser etched the 68 Barracuda, the Modern Racer logo. And these come with custom length hoses. So when you buy this from Penske, you can spec whichever banjo connection or 90 degree swivel connection that you want, and whichever length of hose that you want. So you can locate actually your remote canisters wherever you want them. In the rear, the suspension, like I said, it's tied into the roll cage. So under the rear window, which is a bit sealless, just to save some weight. The rear suspension has a 4-link triangulated setup under the car with an 875 emitted slip diff rear end, and then 2 push rods coming through the bottom of the car, coming up on custom designed rocker arms. So the shocks tie into the roll cage instead of tying to stock suspension mounts, which originally on the Barracudas, on all Mopars, you had leaf springs and just a strut. around. So the strut wasn't really holding any of the weight of the car, the lift springs were. So if you were just to replace that with the coilovers, you would overstress this mount. So by tying it into the roll cage, then we don't really have any problem. The back of the car, like I said, we shaved the rear end, repainted the tail lamps and the stainless trim, just to have more of a stealthy look. In the trunk, Radium Engineering has provided us with a fuel cell with a surge tank. So I cut out the top surface of the deck lid. Wanted to do, again, with the Trans Am theme, I wanted to do a top fuel filler. So you've got the vent at the top here, and then you just fill in here. And when you pop the truck open, it all sits on a bracket that's bolted to the bottom of the rear window, and that feeds into a Radium fuel cell with an integrated surge tank. So the fuel cell has three fuel pumps. It's got two lift pumps, one as main and one as backup, just in case we have a problem, and then one pump in the surge tank. And then the rear, the trunk, the deck lid is all hollowed out to make it a little bit lighter. And you can see the roll cage ties into the frame rails on the side. There's a couple of tubing also on the underside as well. And then on the sides, what I did is for the aero catch pins, I had to cut the weather channel on the sides and made a new recess for it so that they would fit. This took away some of the structure, so I tied it back in with a little rod into the roll cage, just so that nothing would move and panel gaps would always stay the same. Going back to the front of the car, you can see on the side the exhausts are coming out in the rockers, so the cells have been cut out so I could recess the exhaust in it. So under the hood, we have the original engine is a 318 LA. So that's a small block, it's 5.2 liters. And what I did is I built it as a high compression, high revving engine. So it's 11 to 1 compression. It revs to about 7,700 RPM. It's original block, original crank and rods. The main thing in the engine bay is definitely the exhaust system. So like I said, I ran into a bit of a packaging issue because I wanted to run 4 into 2 into 1 headers just to get the power and the torque curves that I was looking for. So, and I wanted these to be equal length headers. So that means that every tubing that comes out of one of the cylinders is the same length as the other ones. So that this way, when you merge them at the right spot, you actually get better airflow. So you don't get like two cylinders airflow merging together at the same time and kind of getting strangled a little bit into a tighter section. So to do this, I had to run about 52 inches of tubing for each cylinder, which in an engine bay for an A-body is pretty tricky. So what I did is I actually ran up and over the fenders and then behind the front wheels and out the sides. So on the driver's side, you can see cylinders 1 and 5 actually go together, and then 3 and 7 go together because of the firing order. On the passenger side, it's cylinders 2 and 4, and then 6 and 8. I tried to do it as much as a mirror image as possible, but the engine is a little bit moved to the right from the start. It's the stock position, but it's a little bit offset to the passenger side. So packaging was a little bit tighter on that side. So I ended up doing a couple of bends a little bit differently, but overall they look pretty symmetrical, which is what I was looking for. In the end, this is all Vibrant Performance 321 stainless steel, which is a little bit lighter. You can run thin and warm. It provides you better heat dissipation, and it also resists better to corrosion and just lasts better on the long time usage. I will have these Cerakoted later on, just to have a bit of a cleaner look. I'll probably match it to the wheels. And then the rest of the engine bay, we also have a few other Vibrant Performance items, like all the fuel lines, the fittings, the heat sleeving for the fuel system, the oil system, because I have an oil cooler in the front, so I have a remote oil filter here. And then the lines run all the way at the bottom, so they run alongside the sump and they stay away from the heat of the exhaust. So that's it for the build on the CUDA. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to hit us in the comments. I'll be happy to answer any questions that you have.
Bye.